Okay, so I've decided Ken's not for me. Ken's not for me. Ken's not for me. Ken's not for me. So what do I do? Bitch! Okay, what am I doing here? Oh my god, you want me to do all those moonsaults? I can't do all those moonsaults. That's too difficult for me, man. I'm a scrub. I'm not even saying that, like, trying to be facetious or anything. I'm a scrub. I'm a lad. Doing how much damage? 4,500 exactly. Yo, they playing that shit out. They playing that shit out from the damn beginning. Oops. Oops. Oh, that did work. Okay. I don't know what I'm doing here. What am I doing here? I'm not gonna be able to do this damn combo. I can't even get... Oops, that was the wrong button. Dude, seriously, I can't even get the cancel into... How am I missing that cancel? Oops. My bad, I need to learn that moonsault shit. Oh my god, what's Garu dying? Oh, okay, 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 okay. Nice. Wait, well done. Well done. That's not gonna get me killed at all. God damn, I've no, maybe I should just let this dude like roll on his own. Just let him go. I'm just fucking going nuts there. I keep hitting the wrong buttons. I don't know why I keep doing a BD instead of... Did it again. I like that. I kind of like that though. Like, it's a rhythm. Gotta listen to the rhythm, man. Oh, there we go. I fucking did it. I fucking did it. Finally hit the right buttons. I never do that. Oops, that's wrong shit. Guess it would help if I actually did the right shit. Still not doing the right shit. Hey, why didn't you do it? There we go. Okay, 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 okay. Nope, wrong button. This is my Persona 4 Arena experience in a nutshell. Oops, wrong button. Damn it, wrong button again. This is just everything that I do incorrectly. Oh, wrong buttons again. I didn't hit the last crescent slash anyway, so it doesn't matter, but still. Fuck, I keep doing it. I keep hitting C. Whenever I want to hit B, I hit C. And whenever I want to hit C, I hit B. I don't fucking know why. There's nothing in there. There's literally nothing in, like, my muscle memory that says I should be doing that. But for some reason, I fucking am. It's really frustrating. That's too late. Oh, I missed it again. Did it again. Too late. fuck off. Be patient. Did it again. Started out trying to do neutral. Neutral doesn't work. I gotta have a direction. Too late. Oh, not too late. Shit! That was too late now. I did it again! I mean, technically, I did the combo, but I didn't do the SB Garudine. Shit. I'm hitting the buttons too fast now. Hit. Started that too slow. Come fuck on, bro. Did it again. I hit A and C instead of C and D. Held the direction first. Oh, you bastard! I actually hit the right buttons that time. Fuck that up. I'm fucking up the rhythm.
You gotta have the rhythm of the dance, the rhythm of the rhyme.
Finally! I fucking suck. Alright, let's see. Yeah, man. Oops. Oh, that's easy. I need to remember when I do. Oops. I need to remember when I do. Like, I need to let him go over first and then do it. Because I keep trying to do it. That's actually one of the things that I keep doing in combos. I'm doing everything too quickly. I'm doing everything, like, instantly instead of... Oops, shit. Maybe you do have to do it after the first one. You do, because you're not close enough after. Okay. Wrong buttons! Isn't that an unblockable though? Or not an unblockable, but it's unescapable. That's the way you get it. You do a throw and then you do that shit. And you can't get out of it, so that's you get that no matter what. I have to give Ken one thing though. He's actually really good against that kind of shit, because you can still control Koromaru neutrally. So you can neutrally. You can still use him naturally, so you can just like spam 2C or regular C with Koromaru and just hope he gets the hit while you focus on blocking correctly. Thing again. Yeah, see, you have ages to wait on that dash spring. Oh, good god. Oh, does he have it? He has chains? Oh. Stays out there for 5 years, though. Jesus Christ, that dash, dude. Fucking dash. Okay, so anyway. I need a demonstration of this. Like, there's nothing about Yosuke, honestly, there's nothing about Yosuke that, like, I don't like about this character. So wait, So as long as you're in Tsukukaja mode, you just get to use that shit? It doesn't take meter? Because obviously he didn't even get any meter back, he got like 10 meter back at the very beginning, and then he didn't gain anything else throughout the rest of the combo. But yeah, there's no way I'm gonna be able to do that right now. Let's check out the rest of his Chalion Jaws. Oh, that one doesn't look too hard. Oh, see, look at that. Is it a Tent? It looks like it's a Tentarafu reset. Oh no, combos. Cool. Yeah, that one doesn't actually look that hard. Holy shit! Oh, it's the Sukuka. Okay. It's the, you know, you do a big-ass combo and then you go into... Oh, it's a fatal counter combo off of a hit that you're very rarely probably going to get. Oh my god, that fucking damage, dude. I actually watched, Jesus. I watched a guy, I believe his name is Niza Pachi or something like that. He uses Shadow Yosuke. Uses Shadow Yosuke ridiculously well. Made him look fantastic. And honestly, I want to, like, I believe that this character is the one that I will have the most fun with in the game. And it's just a factor of getting my execution to the level of being capable of using him. And, I know it's not there yet, and I need to learn a few things. Like, I've heard about this character's glide. I've heard about... So what is... You have to use 3 Tsukukajas? What's Mirage? I don't even know what Mirage Slash is, to be perfectly honest. What's Mirage Slash? Okay. So do you start with a fatal? You don't even start with a fatal when you want me to? Oh, I didn't even combo. No, anyway. Let's go. Let's see what they got for Shadow Yosuke. And then I'll explain why I'm here. Why I'm doing this.
This place exists between dream and reality.
So obviously this is just... Very well. Every shadow character, their first challenge is the shadow version's, Oh, sorry, I got something in my eyes. Being fucked up. Come on, eyeball. Every single one of their first challenges is just the shadow version's, auto combo. I don't think that's even any different. I don't think. Holy shit. Let's just watch a demonstration. Let's just do that. How about that? Oh, that's not that hard. Why would you use? That's really fucking weird. Why would you bother using Shadow Frenzy in that? Like, nothing in there uses meter until the guard. That's weird. Like, I would at least expect there to be, like, like SB moves or. See, same thing right there. There's really. He's not using any meter. Up until the. Tsukukaja, but the Tsuku. That's. You don't need to waste your 100 meter in shadow mode in order to just use that one Tsukukaja. See, that was something that I would expect, using a bunch of SB moves in order to use it, and then, you know, you can use SB Gardevoir at the end, but that's still, that costs you 100 meter. That combo costs you 100 meter. It's not something that, like... Oh, okay, so this isn't... It's gonna tell me, no cheating! How many Tensorifus? Is that 8? That's 9, right? I'm counting correctly? 9 Tensorifus in one combo? I don't even want to know how the fuck he's supposed to do that. So, yeah, so let's just roll back, and I'll just explain really quickly why I want to play Yosuke. Honestly, I feel like Yosuke and Aegis are the only two characters in this game that are actually, like, truly mix-up-based rushdown characters versus every other rushdown style of character in this game is just pressure-based. They're not mix-up-based. This is kind of, I need to explain where I'm coming from in regards to mix-up, because obviously anything that is going to change how you block or how you react is mix-up. That's basically what mix-up is at its most fundamental level. But when I say, you know, like, they're not really mix-up characters, they're pressure-based characters, I mean, just imagine Relius. Relius is a character that he really doesn't have ridiculously strong mix-up by himself. But it's by virtue of his almost endless pressure and making you sit there and respect, like, 5 different mix-up opportunities while he's pressuring you that makes him such a strong character. And so, because that's how basically every character in this game is. Every character in this game that is considered good, aside from Yosuke and Aegis, and I'll get into why there are, that is why, you know, Aegis was considered one of, if not the best characters in the game, in the first one, and Yosuke, I would say Yosuke and Teddy were probably the strongest characters in regular Persona 4 Arena that were slept on the most. But in this game, Yosuke is considered the best character in the game. And it is because he has extremely strong pressure, a very threatening neutral presence, and ridiculously strong mix-up. That's something that most other characters are missing, is that mix-up that he has. And that's why he's considered the best character in the game. And then I think, the one that I'm not sure about here is Mitsuru, but I would say top five in this game, Yosuke, Yu, Sho, Aigis, Mitsuru. Now, like I said, Mitsuru is the one that I'm not really sure about. I just know that she's a very, very strong character. You honestly might be able to put Akihiko in that spot too, just because Akihiko is... Whoo, boy, that boy does damage. But I'm not really... I don't, just because Mitsuru has such a better neutral game in general that she can kind of force you to play her game, whereas Akihiko is basically like... You know, he doesn't really have a strong neutral presence, but his pressure is fucking nightmarish. So that's why I'm not really sure about those two. So I guess let's just say top six, in my opinion. But that also doesn't include any of the newer characters that I don't really understand yet, which are Adachi, Yukari, Ken, Risei, and Mitsuru. I don't really understand those characters at all, so I can't... Mitsuru, Marie. So I don't know if they would fall... I don't think any of them would fall within a top five range. I don't think any of them are that good. But I do think Ken and Adachi are very good. But those are the two characters that I understand the most, aside from... I think Yukari is actually pretty good too, but I know I'm very, the only Yukari I've ever seen was like an 812 PSR Yukari or something like that from Japan. I want to say it's Tahichi. I know it's an Asriel player because I recognize the name, but I can't remember 100% of whether or not it's Tahichi or if it's somebody completely different. But yeah, so the top five characters in the game all have common elements. A dominating neutral presence and ridiculous pressure. And then Yosuke, who is considered above and beyond all of these characters, also has the best movement in the game and the best mix-up in the game. Well, I guess in Orgia mode, but the problem with that is she's not always in Orgia mode, whereas Yosuke is basically always dangerous. And then when he turns on Tsukukaja, your life is just... Peace out. It sucks to be you right now. It's too bad he got Tsukukaja and he's gonna fuck you up now. Versus Aigis, where, like, you know, if she's not in Orgia mode, she's really not all that dangerous. She's still very good, but she's only scary when she's in Orgia mode. And even then, like, I would say I am far more frightened of Tsukukaja Yosuke than Orgia mode Aigis. But anyway, Yu, Sho, Mitsuru. Every single one of them, ridiculous neutral, extremely strong pressure, but not very good mix-up. Their mix-up isn't great. They just put you in block stun and force you to sit there and accept a constant string of, like, am I going to get thrown here or am I going to get punched in the face? I guess stabbed in the face with these particular three characters. Like Mitsuru, that was basically Mitsuru's entire mix-up. She basically had two mix-ups. Very straightforward, simple character in Persona 4 Arena. She either came up and threw you, or she 5B'd you, because 5B is throw invincible. She does that little hop thing in the middle, so she's considered airborne for the duration of it. And that was basically her mix-up. And then her only other mix-up was JB, Rapid JB. That's it. That is Mitsuru's mix-up in a nutshell. Whereas, obviously, you know, Yu in Persona 4 Arena, he just had, you know, he had everything he has now on top of a ridiculous vortex. Except for some reason, they decided to give him a command grab in this game, which is just fantastic move. Why would you do that? Why would you give a character with the abilities of Yu a command grab? Y'all motherfuckers are stupid. And then you get to Akihiko, who, this is why I'm not sure if I would consider him stronger than Mitsuru. Is because Akihiko doesn't have a strong neutral game, but he does have a ridiculously strong pressure game. And if he touches you, whoo boy, peace out to your life. You are going to eat all of the damage in the world, and it's even worse now than it was in regular Persona 4 Arena, where he was already considered a very strong character because of his pressure and his damage output. But now his damage output is worse because he has more options. He has a higher tornado meter, and like when you get hit with a max tornado meter uppercut super, whoo boy, it's like getting hit with red axe. I mean Labrys. It is just bad times. This character does ridiculous damage, and he is very scary because of it. And so that's kind of like basically everything this game is about. It's all about the pressure. It's not really about the, I don't think I've checked out Shadow Akihiko. Let's check out Shadow Akihiko. Very well. I mean, I think the only characters in this game that, like, the Shadow versions have received any kind of attention. I know Shadow Naoto and Shadow Chie are considered pretty strong. And I have seen a dude, I talked about Nezupachi, who used Shadow Yosuke to great effect. Very scary. Okay, so this dude has... he has old. I think he does the boomerang hook automatically, right? Does that actually... oh, okay, cool, it does. I need to get used to using that hop. I honestly don't think I ever used the hop a single time when I played Persona 4 Arena. Oh, you know what? Maybe you can't. Because it looks like... yeah. You got a lot of landing recovery on the hop. You, like, cancel it? Oh, no, it doesn't look like... it does look like... it really doesn't look like you can do that. Which is odd. Like, what the hell's the point of having the hop if, like, you have such extreme landing recovery that you can't even confirm it into a combo? Let me just mash. There we go. I don't understand what the hell is this, like, how is that not working? How is he not in range? Oh, is it because I'm in the, is it some weird corner thing? Yeah, it's definitely some weird corner thing, because he landed way the fuck closer. Alright, anyway, let's just see what the rest of his shit is. The one thing I think they should do... he's doing no damage, dude. That really didn't do damage for what, like, for what that was. You would definitely get far more damage out of using, like, proper SB shit. Oh, here we go. This one better do, like, 9k. This entire combo ending in all those cyclone uppercuts. Oh, but he has to, okay. So yeah, it's the same kind of thing. I mean, obviously, that's still fucking crazy damage. But I thought it would do a lot more, but since you activated Shadow Frenzy, that, the activation... double uppercut. Oh, so that's just regular uppercut? Yeah. Have I done I've done Shadowkin.
Welcome to the Velvet Room.
I don't really have anything else. I'm kind of just trolling around and wait. I'm just waiting for PSN to update. Let me actually check and see if anybody on the internet has news that PSN has been updated. Nah. I assume if PSN would be has been updated, people would be like, "Hey, Margaret's out," rather than other talking about anything else. This is a space. So yeah, I'm just kind of waiting for
entered into a contract may enter.
I was waiting for Margaret to come out so I can try her out, see how it's gonna work, and then I'm just, I honestly believe I'm gonna switch to Yosuke. In some way, I'm gonna utilize Yosuke. And this is one of those things where it's kind of just been like, I need to improve my execution. I'm very well aware of it, and Yosuke utilizes a lot of the things that, well, basically, my execution issues essentially lie in dashing. Movement. Not really, you know, doing motions, not really doing combos. I'm pretty solid on those. The one thing I have learned is that I do need to tighten up my, it shouldn't really be a problem now that I'm not using Ken, but the problem with Ken is that he uses constant quarter circles. Like, at any point in time, you could be using 3 or 4 quarter circle moves in a row with Ken, and quite often I kept getting accidental double quarter circles, which is obviously terrible. None of his things are particularly safe, so it sucks every time you get it. But yeah, I mean, you know, doing motions, doing combos and stuff, that's not an issue. But dashing is an issue, and this character needs dashing in order to do, you know, like his glide shit. Let me actually see if I can't find a really quick dust loop. Don't let me down. Where's Yosuke? There's Yosuke. Oh, hey, look at that. They have a topic specifically for gliding. All right. So, the notation would be jump 66A. Okay, let me see. Let's just jump into using him. Let's just go here. Who gives a shit?
Your head, your own appearance at very well.
Oh, actually, I should have given shit. Because he's going to be attacking this entire time. Okay, so now I can. So jump 66JAB. Oh, wait. I don't understand. Oh, I get it. The JAC is to turn around. Wait, so that can't be right. There's no way that's... Oh, hang on a second. Let me just... Let me mute this so it doesn't actually end up on the capture at all. Okay, so let's see here. Thanks to a Kara cancel, canceling the startup on one move into another with JAB into air turn. Gliding will allow Yosuke to keep his... See, that's just... That's... I don't understand what's going on here. Like, I don't. Like, this dude says the notation for gliding is jump 66JAB A plus C. Oh, you have to plink A plus B to C. I'm not seeing it. Like, I'm hitting these buttons as fast as possible. And I'm not seeing it. That's actually kind of dirty. Like, I think that's a cross-up. Not that I can recreate it. Oh, I did it! That wasn't it. I did it a couple times. Ah, I did it! Oh, do you have to go? Oh, wait a minute. So do you have to? Do you have to have the? I'm kind of doing it. Or is that just like? Am I just? Okay, no, I'm not. I just wanted to make sure I wasn't just, like, turning around in the air and that's how it worked. So. Damn, this is weird. There we go. Oops. That's weird. God damn, people that can do this consistently. Kudos to you. Oh wait, no. This is fun. Like, this is actually just kind of fun. I mean, obviously it'd be more fun if I could actually do it. Nope. Oh, can you check? Yo, I need to do that in a match. So fun. I don't know why. I'm fucking weird. Alright, anyway. Damn it, I had it for a bit. Yeah, it doesn't look like it's that good for instant air dashing, but. Let's see here. Everybody's talking about mapping, like, extra buttons to plink. Fuck that shit, man. Wake up! So I guess if you want to, like... Can you do... Yeah, so you can get... You can do it at different times in the dash. That's really not... I mean, it's not... Obviously, I'm not very consistent with it, but that's really... That's not... That wasn't it. That was not it either. That was it. What's his JA like? Why are people saying to use JA? His JA looks like shitty hip. Oh, okay. That wasn't it. There we go, okay. But yeah, I mean, mostly I would say the biggest issue with doing this shit is gonna be... You know, proper spacing, like right now where I'm not really getting anything. Oops. Not that. Yeah, but like that just... Damn. Like look how... He's out of block stun for like a quarter of a second. Barely any time at all. So how does that work in the corner? Like, do you just not want to do glide mix up in the corner, I guess? Because, like, I mean, obviously you don't want to be turning around. Or maybe it's just like, I don't know. Anyway, that's obviously something I need to figure out. But yeah, man, I actually, that was probably, I'm actually have kind of enjoying that. It's... Okay. There's a lot of land recovery there. Oh, you don't even have to do... I didn't even know you didn't even have to hold that shit down in order to get that to get it done. Alright, so anyway, I'm done fucking around with Yosuke on camera for now. But yeah, I am just... I know for a fact I'm done with Ken. The homie does not mesh well with what I want in a character, with my playstyle, with my mentality. And so, unfortunately, I am pretty much... I'm outie on Ken. I think I'm gonna learn this character. We'll see if I actually manage to learn this character, but yeah, at this point in time, I definitely would say Yosuke is my go-to bro, and we'll see what happens when Margaret pops off.